people are understanding something, are bringing peace in their lives. And you can be a part of the magic regardless of where you are. Wonderful today to be talking about peace, about this life. This is not about religion or philosophy or somebody's ideas, but it has everything to do with a very simple reality. And I'll say this, to begin with, that today is a really special day. In fact, today is so special, so amazing, that you may not remember how special it actually is. So I will tell you. I will tell you why today is so special. Today is the first day of the rest of your life. Today is the first day of the rest of your life. So don't you think it's special? I think it's very special. But see, we forget. We forget what it means to be alive. We forget the value of this breath. We forget that whatever happens, whatever happens, there is another reality. We know about our weaknesses. We do. Our weaknesses are our doubts, our fear, our misunderstandings, our guilt. These are not our strengths, these are our weaknesses. But because today is such a special day, I think we should talk about our strengths. Because our strength is absolutely amazing. I'll give you a small story. There was a man, and he bought a neglected piece of land for quite cheap. And it had been neglected for years and years, and everywhere there was weeds growing, rocks. And he worked really hard. And he cleared the land, and he plowed the fields, and he started to grow crops. And as he did this, he became quite rich. He would sell his crops, he would get money, and he would buy gold. He got married, he had children. And when he got to the ripe old age of retirement, he was quite rich. He was quite rich. And so he took all that gold he had and he put it in a box and he buried it in his field. Time came for him to go, and when he was on his deathbed, he called his children and he said to them, he said, take care of this land and plow the fields. Take care of this land and plow the fields. And everything you have always wanted, you will have. He passed away. The children looked at the land and said, you know, we don't want to live here. We want to live in the city. We want to get jobs. We want to do all those things. There is nothing for us here. Nothing. So once again, the land was being disused, neglected. Same thing happened. The weeds started growing, dry, dusty, ignored. And once again, a very poor man came along and made an offer for the land. The children to whom the land belonged, they wanted nothing more than to get rid of it. So anything they could get, any little money they could get, they were happy. They sold it. And the man started working hard, clearing the field. And what did he do? He plowed the field. And when he did, when he plowed the field, guess what his plow hit one day? The box full of gold. And indeed, he dug it out, and of course he had everything he always wanted. He was richer than he could have ever dreamt. This life, this existence, too, is a field. And there is something wonderful buried here. In this existence itself, there is something wonderful buried. The happiness, the peace, the tranquility, the serenity, the joy. But we have other plans. And even though we're trying to make a success of our lives, this field of existence gets neglected. What happens? Why is it that in our lives we don't take the time to tell the ones we love, I love you? Why? No problem to say, "Oh, good morning," to somebody you don't even know. Hello. But you have to think about this. And I'm not going to tell you today you should tell those you love that you love them. That's up to you. But the question is, why is it? Why is it that we don't take that time? Because it doesn't take long to say, "I love you." A father brings home gifts for his children because he wants to make them happy. But the father has forgotten that that child would rather have the love. Because if there is that love from that father for that child and the father brought no present, it would be fine. It'd be fine. But we are trying to do one thing and accomplishing something else. Why don't we look within ourselves for the source of peace? Why does it have to be something else on the outside? Why do we not search for contentment All of you, I know I am guilty of this, and all of us are. We set our standards. We say, "This is what I considered success," only to readjust it when it doesn't go. It's okay, but okay, it was okay. It was all right. It was fine. Why? Why does your success have to be readjusted? Because there is one success called contentment that does not have to be readjusted. The contentment that comes from the inside. I'm going to tell you something today. You ask other people have asked you, "How are you? How are you?" You go to your office, "Hey, how are you?" You meet somebody, "Hey, how are you?" You go in an airplane, "How are you?" You go buy a ticket, "How are you? How 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 are you?" And like a parrot, we say, fine. And you, fine. And you, and fine. And you, "Oh, I'm good, I'm good. I'm fine. Oh, yeah, thank you." But how can you ask the question, how are you, if you don't know who are you? The first question that needs to be asked, who are you? This you need to ask of yourself, who are you? And then once you know how, once you know who you are, then you can say, I am fine because this is who you are. So do you know who are you? Who are you? Your name? John? This is who you are. You know how many Johns there are in this world? My name is Prem. You know how many Prems there are in this world? Many. So who am I? Who am I? This face? Is this who I am? My face? No. This body? 70% water. You are 70% water, you are 70% water, you are 70% water, you are 70% water, I am 70% water. 30%? Some skin, some bones, some organs. Is this who I am? Or is there something else that's going on here? Is there something else going on? What makes me feel happy? What inspires me to enjoy? What inspires me to be fulfilled? What inspires me to be content? Do I know? Do I know? Or is it every day? Oh yeah, I want to be happy. Let's see what will make me happy. Let's go watch a movie. That'll make me happy. Then people go to the movie, they sit down, they pay their good money, they sit down. They're watching. Some are crying, some are laughing. And then it's over. Get out. Hello, welcome back to reality. Where is your car? You have to go home. Maybe a few comments. Oh, that was a nice movie. That's your happiness? That's it? Hour and a half is your happiness? Oh, let's go for a picnic. Make food, pack everything, and of course, forget some things. Then you go out, you find a place. Is that a good place? No, that's not a good place. Let's find another place. And not everybody agrees to the place where you're going to have fun. No, that was a better place. Oh, we should have gone there. We should have gone there. I told you we should have gone there. And then you sit down, you start to enjoy. And okay, now we are all going to enjoy. And if everything goes according to plan, fine. If it does not go according to plan, it becomes a disaster. That's your enjoyment? Or is there something more? Is there something real that I can count every single day of my life to enjoy? And why? Is it important for me to be happy? Why am I not satisfied with crying? Why am I not satisfied with being upset? I mean, that's what we practice every day, right? Getting upset. There was a man, he was an archer, and he was very good at it. He would take his arrow and his bow and he would shoot at the target, and he was really good. And so he would go from village to village and he would exhibit his skill, shooting the bow, the arrow, making the target. And everybody would applaud. One day he was at a particular village and he was showing his skills. And there was a man in the back. Every time the archer would shoot, he would say, "Oh, it's only a matter of practice." And upon hearing this, the archer got very upset. Everybody is applauding, and then all of a sudden, this idiot in the back is saying, "It's only a matter of practice. It's only a matter of practice. It's only a matter of practice." So the archer, when he was finished, he went looking for this guy, and there is this guy, and he's sitting there, and he's an oil salesman. He sells oil. He's got two big clay pots full of oil. He carries them on a bamboo, and he sells oil. He's got a bunch of bottles with him, and he's there saying, "It's just a matter of practice." So the archer went to him, and he said, "Wait a minute. I'm so good. I do my demonstrations, and everybody applauds, except I heard you sitting there going, 'It's just a matter of practice, it's just a matter of practice.' What do you mean by 'it's just a matter of practice?'" So the oil salesman said, "Watch this." So he took a bottle, empty bottle, put it on the ground. He took one of those old coins that had a hole in it, put it on top of the bottle. He took the big clay pot full of oil, put it on his shoulder, and started pouring the oil from the clay pot. And without even touching the coin, right through the hole, he filled the bottle with the oil. And he said to the archer, "You practice archery, you are good at it. I practice pouring the oil, I am good at it. I could never shoot arrows like you, and you could never fill the bottle like me." Now, it's a nice story. But it begs a question. What do you practice? Whatever you practice, you are going to become good at it.
really good. So, what do you practice? Do you practice anger? Because if you practice anger, you will get good at it. I mean, instantly you could get upset. Doesn't take warm up, idling, nothing. Just out of the blue, boom, anger. Not too long ago, I was in Sao Paulo, and there was a traffic jam. And people were getting very upset. And they started honking their horn, all of them. And the noise was unbelievable. Everybody honking their horn. And I said to myself, these are educated people, they are, you know, smart people. How, and this is physics involved here, how do they think blowing their horn is going to help the traffic jam? How? I mean, is it going to like produce enough pressure of sound that it will move the cars in front? No. And are they at that point where they are stuck, making it worse? Of course. Because before it wasn't that noisy. Now it's noisy. It's hurting their ears too. But, because this is what we practice. If you practice ignorance, this is what you're going to get good at, ignorance. Ignorance. It's a very strange little word, ignorance. It really is. It's really very strange. One day I had to look it up in the dictionary. What does ignorance really mean? So I'm looking at the English dictionary, ignorance. Not knowing. Then I came across the word where ignorance came from. The word ignorance came from. And the word ignorance in English comes from the word ignore. You know, when somebody, we see somebody, they don't do something right, or we say, oh, he's ignorant. But the root of the word actually comes from the word ignore. When we ignore our existence, when we ignore our strength, when we ignore our possibility, when we ignore our peace, when we ignore our clarity, when we ignore our serenity, the result is ignorance. Ignore. I say to people, this life is a blessing. And I can immediately hear people thinking, oh, nah. Do you know how tough my life is? I have to do this, and I have to do this, and I have to do this. I'm going through bad times in my life. Oh yeah, we have good times and we have bad times. I had heard of AM and PM, morning and evening. But good times and bad times? What is that? You mean there is an element of time? That time that is throughout this whole universe that is good and bad? The truth about the good time is this. When everything goes according to your plan, it's a good time. Because you did it. Your plan. And when things don't go according to your plan, bad time. Here is the dilemma. There is a man who rides a bicycle to town for an interview. And he is praying, please, I want to get there on time. So, you know, I hope my tire doesn't puncture. Nothing happens so I can get there on time. There is a man who has just opened a shop on the side of the road to fix bicycle tires. And of course, he is praying, please, have somebody have a puncture so I can fix it and make money. Whose plan is going to succeed? Both plans are diametrically opposed. You make a plan. Sometimes things go just fine. You make a plan. Sometimes it's a disaster. Nothing goes according to your plan. That's your happiness? Let me ask you this one simple question. You don't have to answer me. This is just for you to answer to yourself. If today is the first day of the rest of your life, what plan are you going to make? Everybody went quiet. Oops. Did I ask you too big of a question? I mean, I think it's a good question. Today is the first day of the rest of your life. What plan are you going to make? Are you going to keep making the same plans that never succeed? You know them by now. You know them by now, but you keep making them. You have learned a lot in your life. You see, learning is a fascinating thing. You don't have to do anything to learn. Take a walk and you will learn. You hear two people talking, you will learn something. You hear a radio, you will learn something. Learning is, brain is an incredible recorder. It records all that is going on, and it's learning. You see two colors somewhere, don't look good, you know this color and that color doesn't look good. You've learned something. You hear a song on the radio and it's really nice, you like it. You just learned something, you like that song. You just learned it. You hear a radio and you listen to a song and it's terrible. You just learned something. You don't want to hear that song again. You meet somebody and they tell you, oh, so and so, my name is, you know, Jack. Oh, you learned something. You learned this person's name. Learning doesn't just happen in schools. Learning is happening all the time. And you are learning and learning and learning and learning and learning and learning, and you will keep learning till the very end. But here's the issue. What have you learned? Have you tuned your learning to learn that which will bring you joy, which will bring you clarity, which will bring you that peace? Or are you learning things that are going to pull you away, further and further away from that joy, from that peace? So, today, being the first day of the rest of your life, you get an opportunity to do it right. Do you know how to do it right? Do you? What does being conscious mean to you? One second of being conscious, aware, can save you a lifetime of problems. One second. Before you get angry, if you could be conscious for 1 second, just 1 second, just 1 second, you would go, I don't want to be angry. But what do we practice the most? Not 1 second of consciousness. We practice lifetime of unconsciousness. And when we practice unconsciousness, we get good at being unconscious. This is our simple little reality. You know, when everything is right inside, when everything feels good inside, there is a birth, naturally, a birth of a feeling. And this feeling is the feeling of gratitude, of thankfulness. When you feel that thankfulness in your life, it's only because the heart is full. Do you feel that feeling of gratitude? A lot of people say, well, I want to hear about peace. You're not talking about peace. I'm coming to it. I'm coming to it. You see, peace is not a tree. Peace is already inside of you. Do you know that? Peace is already inside of you. You don't have to bring it from anywhere. And you don't have to go searching for it anywhere, because it is already inside of you. So, of course, the question is then, why don't I feel it? Good question, right? If it's already inside of me, then how come I don't feel it? You'll be shocked by the answer. And here's the answer to that question. Because you're too busy feeling everything else. You're too busy feeling doubt. You're too busy feeling fear. 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 Will I be okay? What will tomorrow bring? Will tomorrow be okay? What will happen to me 10 years from now? What will happen to me 5 years from now? And if the doctor called and said, I need to talk to you, maybe he wants to talk about golf. Maybe he wants to talk about playing tennis. No. But here's the tendency of the human being. Uh-oh. Somebody said to me, you know, that day is still far away when I will die. It's true. But you're working on it every single day. You have a choice, my friends. You have a choice. Either today is the first day of the rest of your life, or today is the last day of the life you have lived so far. Pick one. For your planning purposes, pick one. So, if today is the last day of the life that you have lived, what have you accomplished? Have you fulfilled all your dreams? Is your heart dancing in contentment? Do you know the reality of life? Or from another duality to another duality to another duality to another duality, days have gone by. Sometimes okay, sometimes good, sometimes bad, at best, totally unpredictable, and you, like a ping pong, bouncing and bouncing and bouncing and bouncing and hoping and bouncing and hoping and bouncing and hoping. Is this the human being? Could this be described? Could this be the description of that temple? In which the divinity dances. Yes, of course. This you, me, all of us are the real temple where the divinity dances every single day. The miracle of miracle takes place here. The gift of breath. The gift of breath is freely given to you. Most people, it's like, what's that? Why are you talking about breath? I breathe day and night. I mean, even if I'm not thinking about it, I breathe. I mean, so what is this big breath thing? I'll tell you. When you were born, you don't remember this. You were too tiny. But when you were born, it was very, 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 very important that you were breathing. And you were blue. By the way, you were blue. And then you took your first breath, which was in, not out, in. The cycle began with you taking the breath in. And as soon as you took that breath in, your color started to change. And you became pink. Then you went on living your life, living. For 70-year average, it's 25,550 days. That's all. And at the very end, this breath, even if you take it in, it'll go out. And then you will turn blue again. So, let's see. The fact that you can walk, that you can talk, that you can think, that you can smile, that you can be an uncle, that you can be a daddy, that you can be a friend, that you can be a husband, that you can be a wife. Let's see, if you didn't take that first breath, oh boy. You couldn't have been a daddy, you couldn't have been an uncle, you couldn't have been a husband, you couldn't have been a wife, you couldn't have smiled, you couldn't have laughed, you couldn't have thought, you couldn't have written a book, you couldn't have read a book, you couldn't have sung a song, you couldn't have heard a song. And then it doesn't mean anything to you. How can that be? How can being such a gift means nothing? We don't even try to understand it. How can it be? Because we're busy with everything else. All the ideas. And when it comes to peace, everybody goes, the world needs peace. The world needs peace. The world needs peace. You know who we are, basically, as a human race? We are the best excuse makers you can imagine. Instead of saying, I need peace, people go, oh, the world needs peace. The world doesn't need peace. Human beings need peace. And what is peace? Oh, we will maneuver the languages to define things. So what is peace? Absence of war is peace. So, if absence of war is peace, then why is it that wars get started again after the wars are over? You see, you're talking about political peace. That's not... Political peace is not the peace that resides within you. War is a symptom, not the disease. When people are in peace, wars could end if that's what they decided. Because the real war begins with you. Playing of the bullets and the people dying is just the playing out of the war that exists in the human mind, in the human heart resides the real peace. And when that is understood and felt, that's when this life begins to change. So, my friends, please let today be the first day of your lives for the rest of the living days. The first day. And with consciousness, with gratitude, with understanding, approach every single day, because tomorrow will be again the first day of the rest of your life. Your opportunity to get it right, not wrong, get it right. To be familiar with your strength, not weakness. And when you are busy, when you are busy enjoying your strength of clarity, of gratitude, of understanding, then peace will dance all around you with great joy. Because that's how it is. That's simplicity. That's you. That's your expression. This is who you are. So, if you understand that this is who you are, when the next time you are asked, how are you, reply appropriately. Not okay. Not just fine. But being who you really are. And then from that place, then you know how to smile, because you know what you're looking for is within, inside of you. You are the stage of the divine. And so far you're alive. That, my friends, is your miracle. Your miracle. There are people who are waiting for some angel to descend down from heaven to come and save them. I have news for you. the angel has descended. The angel has descended. And you know who the angel is? You are. You are. And you are the angel that has come to save you. Do you know that? You are the angel that has come to save you. So, dear angel, get busy saving yourself. Today, being the first day of the rest of your life, would be a good time to start. That's how simple it is. That's all I have to say. That's all I have to say. Everything that I have said, I sincerely hope you already knew. I sincerely hope you knew what I have said today. Now, this being the first day of the rest of your life, don't forget it. Don't forget it. Remember, remember, and get busy saving your life, your existence. Dear angel, bring peace to yourself, because nobody else can do it. It's just you. That is your strength, not weakness. That is your strength. Oh, did you ever wonder what is the purpose of your life? Now you know. You're the angel that has come to save you, so you can be in peace. Thank you so much for listening to me, and please enjoy this life. Thank you.